So, part 5, let's move ahead with our policy. So, we have here gnome session check accelerated. Now, just to be sure, actually, we're not going to do that. We're going to do Deja the monitor. We should be trying it to keep it as simple as possible. What is digital monitor? I'm not sure where it is. And we should also keep it. Let's just first look at my login user type enforcement. Have a look at what I did with console type here. No, with the first one, I guess it was host name. Actually, that did transition and console type. What did I do with that? Console type is also transitioning, so that's also fine. Yeah, we just need to continue. I'm just going to do everything I see, just everything that I see that shouldn't be default. And it's going to be overkill, but nonetheless. That the sessions CHKSL. So now let's see what we have. So here we have this one and so we have check SL. And then I'll just basically some of this is really overkill, but I just don't know yet. That's why I'm just doing it, just to be sure, because well, audit doesn't really log everything, so I'll just have to make sure that everything that's on top that I see is done. And then later, if it turns out that it's not needed, I can remove it. this stuff is ran by desession, so I'll need to change that as well. Desession. App. We have a duplicate declaration. Turns out that I forgot something. Is it that? Line 756. These are all wrong. Christ. Then I need to get into the rhythm again, because it's been a while. Now I just need to get back into the flow. Let's see. This is it. Now it's done. Okay, now that'll be, that's the first, and then I'll need to restore calm, the bath, get back into my flow. Into the flow. Restore calm. V. Base that. Logout. Logout. Kill that friggin' process. Killed. Our search, we have 1221. Is this 1221? No, this is 1121. And that's XEM? Yup, XEM. So out it to allow R and then just my XDMT append that and then make file again, sudo as a module again. And this command really shouldn't need to be confined. It's probably doing some simple task. Anyways, so 22, right, actually 22. But I just need to be sure. 23 is clean. So I'll just do that. Just to be sure. And now we really have DigiDub, and it's actually ran by Let's have a look at DigiDub. PS aux grab my login user. DigiDub, where are you? Have to ignore that for a second. I guess because it does run DigiDub monitor, but I don't think that's actually what it says in the ABC now. Oh yeah, it is. Okay, so we need to take out DigiDub monitor. And this is also run by session. So keep it simple. Low, and then just take this this hard work. care of that. Let's see. Yeah, see, I made that mistake here. It's not DD session. It's just data dip mom. Work. Restore cons feed the month and log out here. Basically, my auto daemon is logging so much now right now that it just can't keep up, or it can't keep up. Should give it high priority, I guess. I guess. Okay, it's not logging. Kill all that stupid process that's hanging there. And logging. Try that again. On to the next. T settings. Data convert. It's executed by num session. Now this data convert. Dset data convert. There. Not everything, again, not everything really needs to be confined, but I'm just doing that because I need to basically figure out what needs to be confined. So in order to do that, I need to basically confine it first and then later determine whether it's actually useful or not, and then maybe remove some of this stuff later. So it's basically a little extra work. Better save than sorry. Save and exit. Make it. Install it. And then restore con the path, of course, don't forget. Just to confirm that it actually restored, and it did. Kill all, actually not kill all yet, let's first log out. Take a look at the ABC denials from 35. Let's see if XVM needs to run that digit up. I would actually be surprised. No, but it does want to execute G session. So that's basically outed to allow R and then my XVM TE. And then basically install again. Yeah, XDM needs to run all these programs as well, but with regard to XDM, we just basically run it in the XDM domain, in one big domain. So now we have 37 at the moment, and we're clean. So let's just do it again. See where we're getting now. Where we get now. Oh shit! Oh, that's no problem though. Actually, it is. Let's just look at my XDM TE. No, no. No, that's fine. It didn't add anything. So cool. Okay, GNOME session runs bash, and then GNOME session runs pulse audio start. So that's the next one. This is such boring work. But you really need to take care of the transitions first. It's just mandatory. Always with writing policy, always make sure that you do transitions before you do anything else. Whether it be file type transitions, role transitions, any transitions. And since we're not even dealing with files yet, but we'll need to do that later, also first make sure that the files get created properly. So then we get this whole stuff all over again, but then for files. And there are some problems there as well. But we'll get to that. All in good time, eh? Certainly takes a lot of time, will take a lot of time, so you just need to accept that. No instant results here, at least not any usable instant results. Let's just make that. Install it. Restore con. Well, you know the drill by now. Out. Kill all that process, that remaining process that for some reason doesn't get killed, and then basically do the out search dance again. We're at 43, so I'll just take it from 42, just to make sure. Nothing there. So that's cool, that means we just can go ahead and start it again. See what we have, and here actually start Pulse Audio is actually running Pulse Audio, so now we're getting at the Pulse Audio dance. And Pulse Audio type doesn't have to be declared because it's already there, so we just need to take care of this. I'll just copy this over. Pulse Audio. Alright. So, type Pulse Audio. We don't need this, but we do need to require it require that Bulls audio exactly. And then we can remove these. And then this needs to be done. And then we are going to have to deal with this stuff. This is Pulse Audio exactly. Pulse Audio exactly, and then this is that. This is also that. And this is Pulse Audio exactly. Pulse Audio exactly. So we're not breaking. We're not breaking. At least we're trying not to break. That's a nice thing about this implementation, Pulse Audio, that it basically doesn't break a lot. Just with regard to XDM, it does break stuff. But other than that, it doesn't break much. Except we're going to have to. Yeah, going to have some issues with file context again. So this is actually the Pulse Audio start X11. Is actually what's running Pulse Audio. See if this builds. And it builds. Let's install it. Then we all need to take care of the file context again. Oh, actually, in this case, we don't. That saves us a little time. Let's log out. Let's have a look at the AMC now. We're at 12:47, so I'll just make it 12:46 to see nothing. Alright, let's kill all the processes that are left. Let's try this again. Let's try that. Let's see what we have, and let's move on from there. So this is the MCCP, the grab, the bash, and then we have here the Spice VDA agent. That's the next one, which is ran by GNOME Session. So this needs a file context though. FC. And I'll just make that VD agent. VD agent. Keep it simple. I'll copy this over. Copy. Save and exit. Type enforcement. VD agent. And then I'll just use something applicable. This one, for example, so that I don't have to. So, VD agent. VD agent. So here in the tab position, but I'm just recording all this stuff just for reference, and because I know this becomes boring for you for a while because it's just constantly the same, but I'll just document it all because there's always some people coming and asking about defining the desktop, and then I just can just basically point them to this series of videos and tell them, okay, well, this is what it takes. We have a duplicate declaration, so that sucks. We are going to make it an SVD agent. Only for the executable file though. Because that type was already there for some reason. Let's see if this makes it work. Restore conv v. Okay, let's just log out, I guess. Every once in a while it doesn't get back to the GDM screen, but this time it works. All right. So let's see, we're at 12:53, so I'll just make the 12:52 just to make sure. Does XDM run it? Nope, XDM doesn't run it. Then we'll need to kill all the stuff, and then basically we need to just run again. And now just have a look at, see where, how we are advancing. PS aux grab my login user. Let's see, we're advancing a little. Oh shit. Oh yeah, that's where G settings daemon. Oh shit. We need to take care of that. This one is skipped. And now let's just just to make sure. Pulse audio. Earlier. Damn. Even earlier. No, not. Later. I'm just going to grab X11. If you heard that explosion, that's that's just DuPont. They have a permit to blow up the whole goddamn city if need be. Okay, so where were we? 52. So basically, I just confirmed right now that it was actually G session running pulse start pulse audio, because I wasn't sure there, but here it's actually saying that it's G session. I really need to take care of G settings. Grab G. And the settings. GNOME session here. Here it's actually doing that. So GNOME session. I need to take care of this one first because it's. I just going to do this one first. So it's run by G session. GNOME settings daemon. So, back into business. Back to business. I'll just call that DZB. GZB. Type enforcement. Go all the way below GZD, and then we're going to be using this one. Paste that in there, and then just use GZD. GZD, yes. So that we take care of that one, because that process was basically skipped for some reason. We can't have that. We need to work top to bottom. We need to work down the stack. From up to down. Because if we start down, then we're going to have problems later on. That's why I'm just doing it the way I'm doing it now. And I've done this before, so I know all the a lot of these issues that you see. Not all, maybe, but a lot. And I have to say that until now everything goes real fine and dandy, because the last time I tried this, and I did that the more acceptable way last time, but the last time I tried this there were many problems, most of them due to writing the policy in a modular fashion. But also related to Pulse Audio labeling issues, and we're not even there yet, so those might be exposed later. Let's restore conda files. GNOME settings daemon. Restore con vdat. Yep, and then just log out this mother. Yep, and then let's just kill all the processes, kill all the remaining processes, and then let's just take a look at 1300. So I probably should take a break. Oh, that's 1300. That doesn't exist. I should probably take a break soon, because I don't want these videos to be too long. Oh yeah, XDM wants to actually execute that stuff. So grep settings, audit to allow R, and then just append that to my GDM, XDM, TE. And then just run that, and I'll just run that the old way, just to make sure that it's not, I'm not going to do some stupid later. Make policy, install it again, and after this I'll just go and take a break. Quick break, take a drink. But just so that these episodes don't get too long, they should be about an hour each episode, maybe a little longer, but not too long. Have I killed? Yep, I have killed. Alright, so this is it for this chapter.